Good morning, children. Hope you are doing well. Today is 15th of December 2020. In our previous class, we have learned how to make division fact and solve division fact on the number line. Today, we will be doing exercise 5 and 6, properties of division and division sums. Let's begin. Let me explain you properties of division. This is our division fact. 30 divided by 5 is equal to 6. Where 30 is called dividend, 5 is called divisor, and 6 is called quotient. So dividend, the number that gets divided. We are dividing 30 by 5. Divisor, the number by which we divide. So 5 is a divisor here. Quotient, the answer in division. When we solve the sum, the answer that we get is called the quotient. Okay, here first property, dividing 1. When we divide a number by 1, the quotient is the number itself. Example, 8 divided by 1 is equal to 8. It means when you are giving 8 objects to one child, he is getting all 8 objects. So, 8 divided by 1 is equal to 8. When any number divided by 1, we will get the same number as quotient. Second property, dividing by itself. When we divide a number by itself, the quotient is always 1. For example, 11 divided by 11 is equal to 1. When both the numbers are same, the answer is always 1. Suppose 11 objects are divided among 11 children. So how many will each child get? Each child gets 1. So any number is divided by itself, the quotient is 1. Understood, children? Third property is dividing 0. When we divide 0 by any number, the quotient is always 0. Example, 0 divided by 5 is equal to 0. 0 means no number, nothing. When nothing is divided among 5 children, no one is getting anything. So when 0 is divided by any number, the quotient is 0 only. Division by 0 is meaningless. There is no meaning. Understood? Now here, children, exercise 5. We are doing fill in the boxes. Already I have explained you properties of division. So 15 divided by 1. So children, when we divide a number by 1, what is the quotient? So 15 divided by 1, the quotient is the number itself. What is the number here? The same number will come here as quotient. When 15 divided by 1, the quotient is 15, the number itself. 0, 0 means nothing, no number. When 0 is divided by any number, so what do you get? 0 only. 0 means nothing, you are not dividing anything, you are not distributing anything to how many children, how many number. So the quotient will be always 0 only. Now, when a number divided by the number itself, when both the numbers are same, 16 divided by 16. For example, if you have 16 chocolates and you are dividing among 16 friends, so how many will each get? 1. So when a number is divided among the same number, the quotient is 1. Right? Now here, 64 divided by 1. When you have 64 objects and you are just dividing among one child, so all 64 he will get. Right? So when a number is divided by 1, the quotient is the number itself. The same number you will get as quotient. Here the same thing, 16 divided by 1. So when a number is divided by 1, the quotient is always the number itself, that is 16. Here also 24 divided by 1.
So when a number is divided by 1, the quotient is the number itself, that is 24. Now the next line, when a number is divided among itself, when both the numbers are same, 8 divided by 8, when you have 8 chocolates and you are divided among 8 friends, so how many will each get? 1. So 8, when a number is divided by itself, the quotient is always 1. Dash divided by 1. So you have to fill in the blank. What number is divided by 1 and the quotient is 10? So already when the quotient, when 1 is divided among a with a number, when we divide 1 with any number, so the quotient is the number itself. So the same number will come here. 10 divided by 1 is equal to 10. Now here 30 divided by blank is equal to 1. So what number you will put? 30 divided by dash is equal to 1. The same number. When a number is divided among itself, the quotient is 1. So 30 divided by 30, the quotient is 1. The answer is 1. Right? Now here identify the dividend, divisor and quotient in 18 divided by 3 is equal to 6. So 18 is your dividend, 3 is your divisor and the answer, that is the quotient. So only number you have to write here, 18. Dividend is 18. Divisor is, this is the middle number is divisor and the answer is, that is quotient. 6. Now we are doing exercise 6, one step sum. It is very easy, only you have to be very very perfect with tables. So now 42 divided by 7. So read table of 7 and how many times it goes, you have to write the answer, that is the quotient. This is just one step sum. So we are reading table of 7. How many times it's going? 7, 6 times. 7, 6 are, 7, 6 are, right here 42. Now put the subtraction sign here. 42 minus 42, when both the numbers are same, 0 you will get. So this is your quotient. So right here quotient is what? 6. Got it? Now read the table of 4, how many times it is going? 4, 7 times, 4 sevens are 28. Right here 28, put the subtraction sign, minus sign. Now when both the numbers are same, the remainder is also 0, the remainder is always 0. This is called remainder, okay, this is called quotient. And this is divisor, this is dividend. So here the quotient is 7, right? 36 divided by 6. So read the table of 6. How many times it is going? 6, 6 times. 6, 6 are 36. Put the minus sign here. You have to do subtract after putting the number. 36 minus 36 is 0. So your quotient is, this is your quotient is 6. Okay, these three sums you do on your own. Now children, we are doing division sums, one step sums in our classwork. Now here, 36 divided by 6. So read the table of 6. How many times it goes? 6, 6 are, 6, 6 are 36. So write here 36. 36 minus 36 is 0. Your quotient, you can write short form Q. Your quotient is, this is your quotient is 6. Now here you have to make 6 columns. And please write the numbers properly. And do the sum. Now here, 12 divided by 2. So read the table of 2. How many times it squares? 2 1s are 2, 2.
2s are 4, 2 3s are 6, 2 4s are 8, 2 5s are 10, 2 6. This is also going 6 times, 2 6 are 12. Now put the minus sign here. Put the line on the line here. Do very neatly. 12 minus 12 is 0. Your quotient right here, your quotient is 6 again. Okay. Now read the table of 3. How many times it goes? 3, 5 times. 3, 5 are 15. Now put the minus sign here. Put the line like this. 15 minus 15 is 0. So your quotient is, this is your quotient, your answer is 5. Now here 24 divided by 4. 4, 6 times it goes, 4, 6 are 24. Write 24 in the next box, put the minus sign. 24 minus 24 is 0 again. So your quotient, just leave for two boxes here, don't mix it. Your quotient is again 6. Now 35 divided by 5. So how many times it goes in 5 table? 5, 7 times. 5 sevens are 35. Write here 35, put the minus sign here. 35 minus 35 is 0. This is your quotient, your answer is what? 7. Now the last sum, 21 divided by 7. Read the table of 7 till you get 21. 7 ones are 7, 7 twos are 14, 7 3 times it goes, 7 threes are 21. So put the minus sign like this. 21 minus 21 is 0. This is your quotient. Your quotient is 3. Okay. So put the columns, make the columns like this and write a sum in each column. Here we have done 6 sums. So write each sum in a column and just write the numbers in the boxes and do very neat work. Thank you. We will meet in our next class.